digital radio and online. This is Share Radio.
It's 4 minutes past six. I'm Simon Rose, and this is Share Radio's evening show, getting to the heart of the issues that matter. And it's time for the Entrepreneur Show. EPOS Now, the cloud point-of-sale solutions specialist, is celebrating being presented with the Queen's Award for Enterprise in Innovation. Recently ranked the 13th fastest-growing tech company in the UK, with over 15,000 global customers, EPOS Now was founded by Jason Heavens in 2011. He was running a bar in Norwich when he searched for a point-of-sale system, identified a gap in the market, and started to develop his own solution. I'm now joined by Jason to talk about his experiences as an entrepreneur. Well, congratulations, first of all, on being presented with the Queen's Award for Enterprise and Innovation. Tell us a little bit about your company and how it started.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me on the show. Much appreciated. So I started the business just over 4.5 years ago. And the reason why I started, I was a salesperson in London. And I thought I'd come back to my hometown in Norwich and get away from the hustle and bustle. And start a small little cafe bar. And I realized when I started that there was a lot of cost. There was a lot of cost and a lot of issues there. You know, when you're running a bar, VAT, payroll, profit and loss, and it was all kind of lost on me. You know, as a new business owner, it's really, really tough to start off. And I thought there must be a tool you can use. And that's when I really got onto EPOS there. But coming from a sales background, I had a lot of there was a lot of guys that worked with me, and they were selling things like photocopies. Then they moved on to the mobile phone market, and I realized when I was looking at the EPOS industry, there was no clear market leader, and the market was so fragmented. People were charging people were using sales tactics where they would charge a high level of margin on the product, and there wasn't anyone selling it online. So we came in to revolutionize the industry. What we tried to do was we wanted to sell online. Mm-hmm. So we wanted to sell the product online at a reasonable cost, because the cost before we came in, you were looking at 8 to 10 grand for an EPOS system, and now the market has completely changed. We sort of led the charge on that.
Jason, having never worked in that sort of business, can you explain what an EPOS system actually is and what it does?
Yeah, absolutely. It's an electronic point of sale. So what it is, it's basically a computer that maps your processes. Now, we speak to a lot of business owners that come to us now, and the story is quite similar, and the same story as what I had. And what we see is users phone us up and they say, look, hey, I'm looking to start a bar or a restaurant. And you'll be surprised at how many people don't have a strategy. They will say, so we say to them, go, okay, so your strategy is you're opening a bar, you're going to sell the same products as the person next to you. You know, how are you going to be successful? And what an EPOS system does now in the 21st century, what ours does, is it basically gives them process guidance and best practice. It allows them to use a loyalty system. It allows them to use market automation, so email to all those customers and record all the details. It allows them to manage their reputation online, say TripAdvisor, Trustpilot. It gives them real-time profit and loss information. It controls all their margins for them. It can even handle their payroll and staff performance. And everything is accessible from a smartphone. So basically, what it can do for a smaller sole trader, it can do the job of your marketing department. It can do the job of an accountant. It can do your payroll for you, and it can give you enterprise level features that are really only reserved for your big chains out there. So it can really level the playing field. So what you're doing is you're turning a normal retailer, a normal restaurant business, into a technology business, and giving them all the tools they can utilize to be successful. That's basically in a nutshell.
As you describe it, I can understand how in less than 4 years you've achieved over 15,000 global customers. But I confess my initial reaction is one of surprise that something like that didn't really exist before. Were you?
Absolutely. But the technology and internet and things like that, with cloud computing, you see the advent of cloud now. And with the advent of cloud, well, what that allows you to do, it allows systems to talk to each other because they're in essence connected. So what we do now is we our system allows, it basically is allowed to play nice with other systems. So you have things like Sage, QuickBooks, Magento, which is a website provider. So all of these infrastructure applications can speak to each other. So the technology really didn't really exist before we started up, and it's based on cloud technology. So how that really works is if you're a business owner, you need to think about how you're doing your accounts. So it used to be that, obviously, if you're a limited company, 9 months after the year end, you'd take your box of receipts to your accountant.
Yes.
He'd get his calculator out and go, hey, actually, you lost 20,000, 18 months ago. And you'd be like, okay, that's useful information to know. So now what you can do with the systems, you can integrate with Sage. So you can integrate with Sage or QuickBooks. So you can have real-time profit and loss. And it can do all of your accounts for you. You can even have a drag-and-drop style website to be able to trade online, so you don't have to pay $6,000 or $7,000, for a website. And you can even integrate your card machine to get rid of fraud. But all those systems, all those systems available use cloud technology in order to speak to each other.
So that's
why it kind of wasn't available.
So you realise that there was the...
Well, this is the thing. I mean, the barrier to entry is so hard, for businesses. And that's what we try. That's why I try and educate our customers. So what we do as a business is we have a welcome team that welcomes customers onto the platform. And we educate them, on margin control. We try and make them more effective and level the playing field. And that comes from the experience that I had when I started up. Because I started up, I was lucky because I started up in Norwich, because I was away from, it had its pros because it was cheap to launch in Norwich. The cost of staff was cheaper, the cost of office was cheaper, the cost to do business was cheaper. But there wasn't any people around that could tell us what we were doing. We didn't understand what we were doing at the time was revolutionary. We only put it on the cloud because it made sense. Because we all, iCloud just came out for iPhone. So all of the stuff we were doing, we were just like using Google and trying to figure it out.
How did you start getting the word out? And at what stage did you realize that this was actually a business in itself?
Well, the thing is, the margins were so high in the industry. What we wanted to do is when we figured out, when I was selling mobile phones, I figured out that if you phone people up randomly, it's a very difficult process, right? So what you want to do is find the people who are ready at that moment. So say you're up for renewal at that time, it was a great time to contact someone.
Yes.
Okay. And what the Google AdWords platform did at the time, it wasn't overused. And what the Google AdWords platform allowed us to do is connect with buyers who were ready to buy at that point. So as long as we had enough margin, and we knew how cost effective it was to hire a customer, we could fire a marketing funnel.
I take it you're not now still running that bar in Norwich. Somebody else presumably is running it. What's your plan then for the future, for the next few years?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm better at running a cloud business than I'm at running a bar, if I'm honest. So my plan now is we've just launched in America. So we went to America. We had a chance to go to San Francisco, but we selected Orlando. So it's an interesting choice. That's been open now for 4 or 5 months, and it's scaling up really nicely. So the next thing for us now is we've bootstrapped all our processes. So everything is automated here. So we've done exactly what we set out to do with our system and made our business, all automated. So now what we're doing is we're looking at other regions. So we plan to launch into other regions around the world. So we're taking it to the global stage now.
Jason, fascinating. Thank you so much for talking to us. That's Jason Heavens, who's the CEO of EPOS Now. It's just been awarded the Queen's Award for Enterprise in Innovation. It is apparently the 13th fastest growing tech company in the UK with over 15,000 global customers. Absolutely fascinating. Jason, thank you very much indeed.